Hello. So a very good evening to all of you. How are you all? So basically what happened today in Bank Nifty, let us just first quickly just go ahead and look at the market profile chart of Bank Nifty today. Right. So Bank Nifty yesterday, we talked about, you know, multiple areas on the upper end where Bank Nifty might highly likely take, you know, rejection. We talked about that. And at the bottom also, what we saw, we saw that Bank Nifty, this is the most important area, right, which is which was the remaining area where, you know, if at all Bank Nifty will be breaching, then definitely a good fall is about to come. But what happened? Market again gave a surprise. Market is full of surprises, right? So Bank Nifty, what Bank Nifty did, it opened, gap down, went down in the first tick only and immediately recovered within that tick. And, you know, and then later on, kept on, you know, auctioning again back to the upper area. Now, C period is carrying good amount of importance. Why? Because in C period, we have got, you know, auctioning reversal that took place. And after that, price did not even test that level again. And market then kept on staying sideways. Ultimately, what happened? Ultimately, in the K period, and which I also posted that, you know, that Bank Nifty, good amount of selling has entered in the market, right? So this was the K period low, right? In this particular period, when this selling happened, I posted immediately in the Telegram channel, right? That selling has entered the market, right? Volumes have entered the market, right? So it should be a good, you know, selling opportunity, right? It should be a good selling opportunity. If market really wanted to, you know, keep on pushing further down and down, then obviously this was a very good opportunity, right? But I also posted immediately that do not short immediately. Then this next candle will confirm the real break, whether this is a real breakout or a fake one, right? What happened after that? Instead of net selling in the next candle, market, you know, started showing prices again, you know, pushing again back to the upper end, started auctioning back to the upper end. Buyers got attracted again in this next candle, right? So this might be, that's what I posted, that this might be the stop loss hitting candle for all the longs that were, you know, carrying their positions for the whole day, right? So this might have hit their stop loss, right? They might have exited from their position, and this next green candle was basically, although it was a green candle, but it was carrying selling volumes. And then again, another red candle with net buying volumes, another red candle with net buying volumes, right? So not another net candle, another green candle. It was basically at that point of time red, but yes, again, in this candle, there was another net buying, right? So what happened at the day end? At the day end in Bank Nifty, so this is the chart, right? This was the net selling volume. This candle was carrying huge amount of volume, and you know, market after this fall, market auctioned within this candle. That's what we can say, right? Within this candle, the high got tested, price got the rejection. After, you know, price tested the high of this candle, it got the rejection, and then price went down. When the price reached at the bottom, price again got the you know, rejection within the next candle, and ultimately it started auctioning in the upper end. So what you can do for tomorrow, if at all prices are opening within this range, right? Let me just mark the high and low of this area, right? So if at all Bank Nifty is you know, taking opening within this area, then watch out for the potential breakout that can happen in Bank Nifty tomorrow. The high of this candle is 31770 and the low of the candle is 31677, right? So that's what you can look for tomorrow, if at all prices are opening within this area, right? You can go short below this area, but if you will short, then this area will be the first area that you will have to again watch out, because, you know, as per order flow, that's where the buying auctioning that took place since morning, right? That's where the volumes entered. You can see from here also, when price, in the first candle only, when the price opened, it went down. Look at this big quantity, 32,900. Good quantity started getting traded on the offers. And then price, again auctioned in the upward direction. Next 5 minutes, price again tested the lower end and got the rejection. And after that, there was net buying that kept on happening. So obviously, this area is also will also carry good importance for all of you if at all prices are reaching back to 31,590 or 580. So that's where prices might take rejection. So this is what you can look for tomorrow. If you are shorting, then watch out for this level as well, right? Because this level today at this level, the auctioning reversal took place and there was net buying that happened in the day, right? But overall at the day end, what Bank Nifty is carrying, Bank Nifty, at the day end, it is carrying net long position, right? So this is kind of a bullish indication, but we have to still look at the, world market also. Overall, Bank Nifty has closed red. Value area has also shifted in the lower end. Market has again got the conviction, although this was, really big gap opening, which took place today. But we have to watch out for, another one or two more trading days. But overall, what we can see from 32,350, where price tested the level, two times, it ultimately from 350 to what you can say again 31,550. It has reached today from 32,350 to 31,550 roughly, right? That is where it has reached overall. So prices are basically retracing again and again. But at the lower end, we might see in the coming days, that's what we are also looking for. We might see in the coming days that price might again retest these buyers. This is the day where actual buying took place. If at all prices are again going down to this level, then we should be looking for these levels where prices might take rejection again, right? So this day is carrying good amount of importance. We have to look that as well. And looking at the option chain, I have already posted the option chain in Bank Nifty channel. So this is, what is this telling? This is telling that today, huge amount of call writing that has taken place at 32,000, making that as one of the good barriers as of now this week. And second good writing that has taken place is at 31,900 call option, 31,800, 31,700, as well as 31,600 and 31,500. Both of them were also got written. But we should also, consider the fact that 31,700, 600 and 500, all these put options were also written, but amount of their writing was very less compared to the writing that took place in all the call options. So all the call options, they were written aggressively compared to the put options. Put unwinding has taken place in 31,800 strike price. 31,800 strike price put got unwinded. 31,900 strike price puts got unwinded, which is kind of a very good bearish indication, right? So depending upon the US market, how US market will perform, let's see what happens on Monday. But these on the upper end, these levels are still intact. So watch out for these levels, right? This is the level where auctioning got reversal. And today this bottom got breached, but again price entered back to the same level. So this higher level is carrying good importance. So watch out for today's high price. This is the level which is 31,850 to 31 to the highest high price of the day. And at the bottom, this is the reversal point that I talked about in this just below the K period low, between 31,650, roughly around 31,650 to 550. This is the level which should be watched tomorrow, and I have already shown you where the buying has taken place in order flow. Buying has taken place today at 580 and onwards. So this remaining area to be watched for, if at all Bank Nifty is breaching 570 to 530 with volume, you are good to create another short or add on to your short position, right? And let me know what you think about what you feel about, if you want any more changes to be required in this Bank Nifty analysis. We will keep on doing. We are here for all of you. And if you want to join the course, right, this is the course, Bank Nifty. This is not just about Bank Nifty. You can, you will be able to trade in any futures stocks. This is market profile combo course, and we will be teaching you market profile analysis, volume profile, and order flow analysis, right? And our next batch is starting on 5th of February. Contact us at 9599634604, and trades that we took today, one trade that I would love to show you all, right, which was in IOC, Indian Oil Corporation Limited. I'll show you where we took the trade, and that's how order flow will help you out a lot, right? This was the trade taken by us. I'll show you just a minute. Right, in this particular candle. So today, this was the opening price of IOC. The price started going down, and then again, it started witnessing some sort of buying that kept on taking place. Once it breached the high opening price of IOC. So this is one more learning video for all of you. Right, this is just understand, try and understand what I'm trying to explain here. This is the opening price. Price started auctioning in the first 5 minutes. It started auctioning in the downward direction, and then after 5 minutes, price started retracing back to the upper level, and ultimately it breached the opening price. Right. Once it has breached the opening price, doesn't matter whether the price has opened gap up or gap down, it doesn't matter. This is the opening price. If it has breached the opening price, what you should always be looking at, whether this will invite buying. Further buying, you can say, invite further buying, or this will invite further selling, fresh selling, or you can say, right, whether this will invite buying or selling, that should be your focus point, right? If this is inviting buying, then price will not even look back this particular morning range. Price will just keep on moving up and up. If this will invite selling, then you will see either price will start retracing a little bit from here, and ultimately going back to the lower range, and ultimately it can breach the low price, right? That is the thing that you should always be looking at whenever you are considering the opening price. If you are trading on morning range, and you want to see this kind of thing, right, breakouts, right? So this is what you can consider as breakout. If this is a real breakout, then what will happen? The price will keep on moving up. But instead of that's how order flow can help you all. Order flow told us what? Price breached the upper end. Instead of inviting buying, it invited selling, right? And this was the candle which was absorbed lots of buyers. In this candle, there was good amount of buying that took place, right? And in this candle, there was straight away absorption of selling, and in the next candle, there was again another absorption of selling, and this was straight away net selling candle that took place, right? So these three candles gave us very good confirmation that we have to short. There is no other there is no other option available for us. So what we did, we shorted. Let me show you the screenshot. We shorted IOC at this was the shorting price 123.55. Within this candle, we shorted, and what was our stop loss? Stop loss was simple. 123.55 is our shorting price. We shorted at 123.55. Stop loss was only 50 paisa. 50 paisa stop loss. And risk reward, if you talk about, if you are getting the loss, you are getting the loss of around what you can say around 2000 rupees loss in this trade, right? And minimum target that you can look for is at least double the risk that you are carrying, right? So at least if you are taking, you know, 50 paisa stop loss, you can target for 1 rupee and look at that. After that, you know, the price, although we know that, you know, seller is sitting right there in this candle, right? So when we shorted within this candle, the price kept on staying sideways, making people think that price might again, you know, push the prices back to the upper level. But no, they are not looking at the, you know, this candle. This might, if I just make the chart like this, this might show you, you know, a curve something like this, that prices are moving up. But in reality, what was happening, look at these orders. These are one of the biggest orders that were, you know, getting traded in IOC. And it was, you know, straight away indication that instead of moving up, prices are about to move down. And, you know, slowly, price just stayed here for some like 5, 10, 20, 30, right? I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 40 minutes it stayed here within this range, and after that finally, yes, there came a push, right? When you know, this push came, we just kept on holding. Now what we had to do, we just had to trail our stop loss, and finally look at the move, beautiful move that took place, and finally we booked our profit at 122.5. this was the price, right, where I booked the where we booked the profit. And if you have not understood this chart, I'll show you the chart in this candlesticks also. That's how it looks like. Beautiful movement in IOC. This is just 5 minute chart. Look at this, price has opened here again, started retracing up, pushed crossed the opening price. Instead of inviting further next level of buying, it invited selling. And these three, 1, 2, 3, these candles, these were the candles which were carrying very good amount of volume, which gave us the confirmation to short. We shorted right in this candle, 123.55, and we kept on trailing our stop loss. That's how you all can mint money if you know where the market is heading, right? After this fall, the price kept on staying sideways for good about 40-45 minutes, and ultimately price, instead of moving up, it moved down and kept on pushing, you know, down. And even it made a low of 122. So lot size is like 4000 lot size. If you can, you know, book good amount of money in this, right? So that was the kind of and this is also, you know, look at the macro trend was also, you know, in the downward direction only, right? This is the trend that it was following, so it was also another confirmation that, you know, currently the trend is down only. Even if the reversal wanted to take place, it should have taken place within this candle only. It should have, you know, invited good amount of buying, so that price should have you know, started moving up and up, and, you know, back to this 126 level. Instead of buying, it was net selling. Doesn't matter where the market is moving, if you know, if you have understood the order flow properly, if you know where the buyers are sitting, where the sellers are sitting, you can make your right trading decisions at right point of time. Another trade that we took was in Bata India, which I also posted in the channel, right? This is this was the candle which I was talking about, where we shorted. And another trade that we took was in Bata India, right? In Bata India, what has happened? We bought in this, within this channel, because it was carrying good amount of buyers. And we also posted, this is what we posted, that you know, Bata, there are Bata India is in our watch today, waiting for the breakout. We bought it within the channel, right? And once the volume enter, it will be a very good buy, right? There are net long position in it as of now, and it might blast up provided big volumes entered and keep pushing the prices up. But what happened after the buying entered the market, right? instead of, you know, further next level of buying, further, you know, aggressiveness in buying, instead of aggressiveness of buying, what we said after the breakout, instead of, you know, buying, there is profit booking that is happening in these one, two, three, and two candles. We knew that, you know, we have to book our profit or at least keep our profit in the stop loss, you know, keep our stop loss in the profit zone. So that's why I immediately posted that, you know, just keep your stop loss in the profit zone. That's how, you know, once you are aware of where the market is, you know, heading, where the particular stock is heading, if you understand that, if you have read the order flow properly, you can take your right trading decision at right point of time, right? So so basically what you can do, if you want to learn all of it, just join the course, right? And I'll again post the next video tomorrow. And if you want to talk to me, if you have any query related to the course, you can talk to me. You can take my number from the from my team. This is the number 95996-34604. And next batch is starting on 5th of February. All right. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye. Take care. And have a lovely and happy weekend. Take care. Bye-bye.